So right now, most of the sarcoma patients, osteo Ewing's and rhabdomyosarcomas, are similar in that we have very good upfront therapy. We do multimodality chemotherapy. We often use radiation therapy or surgery in these patients. And most patients will do well. Actually, the majority will do well and respond. Unfortunately, there's another whole subset of patients that are like in the 30 to 40% range that don't, that either have recurrent or metastatic disease. And then the therapy prospects are much diminished. There's not that many options, and I think even when we try chemotherapy again, they become resistant to it faster the more we do it. And the patients are overall healthy because they're young pediatric patients or young adult patients, and therefore I think they're tougher and live on the brute strength of being young and healthy. Unfortunately, that gives us more time to have therapies not work, and then I worry that we don't have another options. So I often get calls, especially being at the NIH, from patients that have tried lots of other therapies and that have failed, and it really propels me to want to give new therapies to these patients. And I do think if we get better understandings of how that resistance works both in the tumor cell and the microenvironment, we'll either be able to repurpose therapies we used in the past more effectively or reintroduce therapies we've used in that patient more effectively if we can use it in combination with other therapies.